Let's see how you can make basic scene transitions like this one, or this one. I already created two scenes. Something like a menu scene with a simple button, and an in-game scene. By clicking one of those buttons, you will switch to the other scene, and vice versa. The scene switching is handled by a script, which is the same for both scenes, just for simplicity. I added the scene management package, and load the scene by their build index. To see the build index, go to File, Build Settings. Make sure to add all your scenes, and there you can see the index number. So, we are going to make a scene transition where a black rectangle grows, then the scene switches, and then it shrinks again. Instead of animating the rectangle, I'm going to tween it. This is way better for your performance. I highly recommend using the free LeanTween library, which is super easy to use and useful in a lot of situations. If you don't want to use it, there are also other tweening libraries, and of course, you can still use the default Unity animations. To download LeanTween, go to the Unity Asset Store and search for LeanTween, or click the link in the description. Like I said, it's free, and you can add it to your assets, and import it. When this import dialog shows up, make sure to deselect the examples. The package comes with all those materials and scenes and scripts. But if you want to see those cool features, you can always install them in a new project and check them out there. You can also deselect the documentation if you prefer using it online. So let's create the object we want to tween. Inside of your canvas, create a new UI image and stretch it over your whole screen. Make sure you don't scale it up. On its max position, the scale should be 1, because we will scale it from 0 to 1 and back for our animation. When you are done, set your game object to disabled so it doesn't annoy you. Make the same or whatever you want for the other scene. Basically, you can have different forms or versions on every scene transition, you know, like PowerPoint 2003. Now open the script which handles the reaction on the button clicks. After a button was clicked, this is the moment we want to animate, and after it is finished, we want the scene to switch. At first, we need a reference to the fader object in the scene. I add a serialized field of the type rectTransform. LeanTween can either tween game objects or rectTransforms, whereas the second one is used for canvas elements like we have one. In the start function, I want the fade out to happen. So the rectangle should be full and shrink to 0. To make sure it is in the correct starting position, I will set this also with LeanTween. In the documentation, you can see the relevant parameters for the scale method. The first one is our rectTransform element. The second parameter is a vector3, where you can set the target scale of all three axes separately. And the third argument is the duration time as a float. This one will have a duration of 0. But right after this, I create a new one which has a vector3, 0 as target scale and a duration of 0.5 seconds. It's always good to disable your game objects again. In this case, it's just not there with a scale of 0. But if you just change the opacity of something, it will always be in front of your buttons and make them not clickable. So LeanTween offers the option to chain methods, which is quite handy now. Because the animation needs half a second, and instead of using a coroutine, we can just simply append this setOnComplete with an anonymous function and do whatever we want after those 0.5 seconds, like disabling the game object. You can now copy the code and paste them into your button handler methods. Just that we want to start with a vector3, 0 and end with a scale of 1, 1, 1. Inside of your setOnComplete method, add the loadScene method. Since we are switching the scene, there is no need to disable the game object. And of course, make sure to enable your game object before any animation. Before going into game mode, make sure to assign the fader to a rectTransform slot in the script. In both scenes. As you can see, everything works fine. As you may know from animations, you can have different animation curves. In LeanTween exist a lot of presets for this. Simply chain the method setEase and from the type LeanTween type, select one you like. You can now see there is a significant speed change in the tweening. And you can also have some scene delay, where you wait on a black screen and then load the next one. The easiest way is to load a scene in another method and just invoke it. When going into the in-game scene, the black screen will now stay for half a second. And let me change the ease to something smoother. Much better. To help you understand LeanTween a bit better, let's try this whole thing for the opacity. In LeanTween, this method is called alpha because it changes the alpha channel from the images between 0 and 1. I simply replaced the called method, set a float instead of the vector 3, and also removed the animation curve. Note that there still is half a second pause when switching to the in-game scene. And of course you don't have to use a default rectangle image. Feel free to use whatever shape you want, like I did with this fish on my Game Jam game, Clean Your Ocean. If you have questions, let me know in the comments. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.